Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to learn about the basic logic gate circuits, exclusive circuits and flip-flop. So to understand these circuit, we have a logic laboratory. Order code for this logic laboratory is 38615. So basically this logic laboratory consists of four module, Logicom 1. So Logicom 1 order code is 38611. Logicom 2 order code 38612, Logicom 3 order code 38613, and Logicom 4 order code 38614. So this is the metallic body of logic laboratory and it consists of four module. So we understand each module one by one. So this logic laboratory consists of five lab manuals. This is the lab manual of 38611 for Logicom 1. This is for 38612, that is Logicom 2. This is for 38613. This is for 38614. And lastly, we have a 38615, which is the order code of logic laboratory. So in this manual, all the detail of all four modules are consisting. So now we are and also some patch code with this 38615. So we are going to study each module one by one. Now I will going to tell you the feature of each module one by one. So this is the Logicom 1 module. The feature of this module is it having a 9-3 input NAND gate, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and each followed by an inverter gate of 3 input NAND gate, and a clock generator is given, and this is the on-off switch. So this is the specification of 38611. This is the Logicom 2. The feature of Logicom 2 is it having a 12-2 input OR gate, each followed by an inverter to give 2 input NOR gate, a clock generator of 500 Hz frequency, and this is the 2 LED indicator. Similarly, this is the Logicom 3. It consists of 6 inverter, 4 2 input AND gates and 4 2 input OR gate, and also it having a clock and logic indicator. Similarly, this is the Logicom 4. So Logicom 4 having the 9 JK flip-flop, 2 LED drivers, sorry, 2 pulsers, and we are having a clock. So this is the specification of each module one by one. So now we are going to understand all the experiment one by one. I'm starting with the Logicom 1. Order code for this is 38611. So our first experiment of Logicom 1 is to verify the AND gate and NAND gate. So this is the truth table given in the manual. So we are going to verify the truth table of AND gate and NAND gate. So now I am going to start the connection. For connection, we are having patch codes. So first of all, I am going to verify the AND gate. So connect the 3 input terminal of AND gate to A, this terminal to B, and this terminal to C. So to verify the AND gate, connect this terminal to LED T1, and for verification of NAND gate, connect this terminal to LED T2. Now turn on the training board. For to turn on the training board, First of all, connect the 230 volt AC main supply. Now turn on the training board. So you can use these switches as per your choice. When the switch in down position, output left hand side input is activated. When it is in up position, right hand side input is activated. So here I am using the input ABC. So for input ABC, if you want input 0 for ABC, you can use left hand side input, and for 1 you can use right hand side input. So here our first combination is when ABC 000, AND gate output is 0 and NAND gate is output is 1. So here initially I am taking the left hand side input 000. So for 0, here you can see when A input is 0, B input is 0 and C input is 0, LED L1 is off means AND gate output is 0, and LED L2 is on means T2 is on means NAND gate output is 1. So you can see here T1 is in off condition and T2 is in on condition. Similarly, when A, B, C inputs are 0, 0, 1, so here input A is 0, B 0. Now I am taking the C input is 1 means I am taking the right hand side input. So to take the right hand side input, press this switch in upward position. Now when input 001, AND gate output is again 0 and NAND gate output is 1. So you can see NAND gate output is 1. For input 010, here input A is 0, so already A is 0. So to make the input B is 1, press this switch is in upward position and activate the right hand side input. Similarly, C input is 0. So to operate this C input, activate the left hand side input and press this switch in downward position. So now at this combination, the LED L1 is off and L2 is on. Again, LED L1 is off and L2 is on. Now we make the connection. Sorry, we make the combination when input A, B, C both are all the inputs are 1, AND gate output is 1 and NAND gate output is 0. At this position, L1 is on condition and T2 is in off condition. Now I am taking input 1, A1, B1 and C1 and make all switches in upward position. So now you can see the LED T1 is in on condition and T2 is in off condition. So this is the verification of AND gate and NAND gate using the inputs in input A, B and C. Now we are going to perform the next experiment, that is the verification of OR function. So our next experiment, the verification of OR function. So this is the circuitry of OR function. When A bar dot B bar dot C bar complement means the OR gate function. So to understand the OR gate verification, this is the De Morgan's law. A bar dot B bar dot C bar is equals to A plus B plus C ka whole bar, and whole bar means the again complement of whole bar is the OR gate. Now to understand this experiment of OR gate, input A bar, B bar and C bar we are going to use. So here connect the input to A bar, this to the B bar and this to the C bar. Connect output F to T1 LED. Now turn on the training board. So initially I am going to use the right hand side input because A bar is 0 in right hand side. So here first of all make the switch in upward position to activate the right side input, and here C bar 0, B bar 0 and A bar 0. When A bar 0, B bar 0, C bar 0, at this input combination LED T1 is in on condition, means output is 1. So you can see here LED is in on condition. For A bar 0, B bar 0, C bar 1, I am going to use left hand side input for C bar 1. So to activate the left hand side of input of C input, press the switch in down position. Now at this position again the LED L1 is in on condition. Similarly you can make all combination. I am using the combination A bar 1, B bar 1, C bar 1. At this position LED L1 is in off condition. So to activate the A bar 1, B bar 1, C bar 1, we have to press the input in down condition and take all input 1, C bar 1, B bar 1 and A bar 1. So you can see when A bar, B bar, C bar is 1, output LED L1 is in off condition, means output is C0. So this is the verification of OR gate. So now our experiment third is the study of function f equals to A bracket B, B plus C. So this is the Boolean function, and now we are going to verify the truth table of this Boolean function. So here truth table of this Boolean function is given. So we are going to verify this truth table. First of all, make the connection as per shown in the figure 7. So take the input B bar, C bar and A input. So I am taking the B bar input, C bar input . So here I am using the B bar and C bar input, and now connect the B bar, C bar input output to the next NAND gate input. So here output of first NAND gate to input to the another NAND gate, and another NAND gate input is A. So we have to take A input for another NAND gate. So here I am using the A input for another NAND gate. Now connect the output of NAND gate to the input of another NAND gate. So it is a common input. So you have to make all the connection common for third one NAND gate input. Now output of that last NAND gate to LED LED T2, and the output of first NAND gate to LED L1. So this is all about the connection. Now we have to make the input as per the manual. So our first combination, when input A is 0, B bar is 0 and C bar is 0. At this position L1 is in on condition, means B plus C output is 1, and L2 is in off condition, means A bracket B plus C is in logic 0. So here A input is 0, so here A input is 0, so we have to activate the left hand side input. For B bar input 0, we have to activate it right side input. So to activate the right side input, press this switch in upward position. So here right side input is activated. So here B bar is 0 and again here it is C bar is 0. So when A is 0, B bar is 0 and C bar is 0, at this position L1 is on condition and L2 is in off condition. You can see here L1 is on condition and L2 is in off condition. For next combination, that is A0, B bar 1, C bar 1. At this position, L1 is in off condition and L2 is in off condition. So I'm going to make this combination. So to make the A input, A is already 0. We have to make B bar, C bar input at 1, 1. So to activate this input, we have to make the switch in downward position for input B and C, B bar and C bar. So when input B bar and C bar at 1, 1 and input A is 0, L1 and L2 is in off condition. So you can see this combination is verified. Similarly, I'm going to verify the next combination, that is when A input is 1, B bar 0, C bar 0, at this position LED L1 on and L2 on. So make the input A as 1. So to activate the input A1, we have to make the switch in upward position and make the input A is 1. So here I have made the input A is 1. For input B bar, C bar 0, we have to make the switch B and C in upward position and make the B bar, C bar 0. So at this position, I have told you L1 and L2 is in on condition. So this, and again we can verify the last combination, that is A1, B bar 1, C bar 1, at this position L1 and L2 is in off condition. So I am going to verify this combination again. Here A is 1, B bar is 1 and C bar is 1. So at this position L1 and L2 is in off condition. So this is the verification of Boolean function F equals to A bracket B plus C. Remember one thing, when the input switches A, B, C are in downward condition, left hand side input is activated. When the switch is in upward position, right hand side input is activated. So this is the basic of this logicom 1. Now we are going to verify the next experiment, that is the verification of exclusive OR gate. So to verify this exclusive OR gate, we are going to make this connection as per shown in the figure 8a. So to verify this connection, I am going to make this connection on this logicom 1. So now to verify the XOR gate, I am going to make this connection. So for this, I am using the input A, B bar, A bar and B. So to take this input, for input A, I am going to connect this A input to this first NAND gate and B bar input to second NAND gate, same NAND gate. And for A bar input, A bar input is for another NAND gate and B input is for another NAND gate. Now output of first NAND gate to the input of another NAND gate and the output of second NAND gate to input of third NAND gate and the output of third NAND gate to the LED L1. Now, as you know, the XOR gate is the OR detector For similar input, it will give the output 0, and for dissimilar input, it will give output 1. So for input A, B, 0, 0, output is in off condition. For input A and B means odd detector, output is on. A, B, 1, 0, output on. And for same input, output is 0. So to understand this XOR gate output, I have to make the input A and input B at 0, 0 position. So to take the input A, 0, I have to make the first switch is in downward condition and left hand side output is input is activated. So here A is 0 and B is, to make the B 0, make the switch in downward position and output B, input B is in 0 condition. So when A, B 0, 0, output is in off condition. When A 0, B 1, output is on. So here A 0, to make the B 1, first of all make the switch in upward position and B is in at 1 input. So when A 0, B 1, output is on, means LED L 1 is glowing. So this is the verification of XOR gate. You can also perform the connection of XNOR gate by using the one more NAND gate. So you can observe, if I am going to connect this output to the input of another NAND gate, so as you know, XNOR is the, for similar input, it will going to give the output 1. For dissimilar input, it will going to give output 0. So when A0 and B0, output is 1. When, so here A0, B0 means similar input, output is 1. Now we are going to take the dissimilar input. So for A1, B0, output is 0. So for dissimilar input, output is 0. This is a verification of XNOR gate. So you can perform all the experiment. For example, here the experiment full adder. So you can perform the full adder experiment by using these NAND gate. Similarly, you can perform the majority logic experiment, even parity check, odd parity check, binary storage element by using the two input NAND gate. So this is basically a latch. So you can perform all the experiment. So this is all about the Logicom 1. Now we are going to perform the experiment on Logicom 2. So for performing this experiment on Logicom 2, we have a manual of 38612 Logicom 2 manual. So our first experiment of this module is to the verification of OR gate and NOR function. So to study this logic gate, we have to make the connection as per in figure 5, and we are going to verify this truth table of OR gate and NOR gate. So here the truth table is given. So we are going to use input A and B. So here I am going to connect the input A to this input of OR gate and B input to this another input. Now connect the output of OR gate to the LED T1, means LED or LED L1, and the output of output of NOT gate on LED L2. Turn on the training board. So here the switch in upward position means right side input is activated. But we have to take the input A0, B0. So we have to activate the left side input. So to activate the left side input, press this switch in downward position. So when A0, B0, output of OR gate is 0 and output of NOR gate is 1. So you can see the output of OR gate is 0 and output of NOR gate is 1. Similarly, for A input 0, for B input 1. To activate the B input 1, we have to make switch in upward position. So when A0, B1, OR gate output is 1 and NOR gate output is 0. So you can see LED L1 is on and LED L2 is in off condition. Similarly, for A input 1, B input 1, output of OR gate is 1 and output of NOR gate is 0. So here A input 1, B input 1, output of OR gate 1 and output of NOR gate 0. So this is the verification of OR gate and NOR gate. Now we are going to verify the next logic gate, that is AND gate and NAND function. So to verify this logic function, we have to make the circuit as per in figure 6, and we are going to verify this truth table of that experiment. So to study this experiment, we have to take the input A bar and B bar. For this experiment, so I am going to use the A bar input and B bar input. So output of first NOR gate to the input of another NOR gate and common input for second NOR gate. So here I have shorted this input for second NOR gate, and the output of second NOR gate to the LED T2 and output of first NOR gate to the LED L1. Now we are going to verify the truth table. So this is the truth table of this experiment. So for when input A bar, B bar 0, the output L1 LED is on and L2 is in off condition. So when input A bar 0, press this switch in upward position, and input B bar is 0, L1 is in on condition and L2 is in off condition. So you can see here L1 is in on condition and L2 is in off condition. Similarly, for input A bar 0, B bar 1. So here A bar already 0. To activate the B bar 1, press input B switch in downward position and activate the input B bar at 1. So when A bar 0, B bar 1, the output LED L1 is in off condition and L2 is in on condition. So you can see here L1 is in off condition and L2 is in on condition. So this is the verification. You can perform all the combination to verify the AND gate and AND function. So this is all about this experiment. Now we are going to verify the Boolean function F equals to A dot bracket B plus C. So to verify this Boolean function, we have to make the circuit as per shown in the figure 7 and verify the truth table given in the manual. So to understand this F equals to A dot B plus C Boolean function, first of all, so I am going to use the input B, C and A bar input for this experiment. So here I am taking the input B for input of first NOR gate and input C for another input of first NOR gate. Now output of first NOR gate to the input of another NOR gate and the second input of second NOR gate is the input A bar. So here I am taking the A bar input, turn on the training board, sorry, turn on the Logicom 2 board and verify the truth table as given in the manual for F equals to A dot B plus C. So when input A bar 0, B 0 and C 0, at that position LED L1 is in off condition. So here connect the output of second NOR gate on LED L1. So when A bar input 0, so here A bar input at 0 position, B and C also at 0 position, so B already 0 and C is at 0 position. So at this combination output L1 LED is in off condition for A bar 0, B 0 and C 1. So here I am taking the input C 1. At this position L1 is in on condition, so you can see here LED is L1 is glowing. Similarly for A bar 0, B 1, C 0, so A bar already 0, we have to make the input B at 1 position and input C at 0 position. So at this combination again LED L1 is in on condition. So you can verify all the combination of using this truth table. I am going to verify the last combination, that is A bar 1, B 1 and C 1. At this position LED L1 should be in off condition. To make this combination, A bar 1, B 1 and C 1. At this position L1 is in off condition. So you can see here L1 is in off condition. So this is all about this Boolean function, that is F equals to A dot B plus C. So our next experiment of Logicom 2 is to verify the exclusive OR gate or OR function. So to implement this exclusive OR gate, we are going to use the 3 NOR gate, and using 3 NOR gate, we are verify the XOR gate output. So as you know, XOR is the OR detector. So for odd input, output is 1, for similar input, output is 0. So to study this experiment, I am going to use the input A, B, A bar and B bar. So here A, B and A bar, B bar is the input for 2 NOR gates. So here for first NOR gate, I am taking the input A, and another input of first NOR gate, I am taking the input B, and the input for second NOR gate is the A bar, and the another input of second NOR gate is the input B bar. Now output of first NOR gate is the input for another NOR gate, and the output of second NAND gate, sorry, NOR gate is the input of another NOR gate, and the output of third NOR gate is the, connect this output to the LED L1, turn on the training Logicom 2. Now for input A, B, 0, 0, output is 0, means XOR output is 0. At this position L1 is in off condition. So here A 0 and B 0. So when A 0, B 0, L1 is in off condition. When A 0, B 1, so I am taking the B 1. So when A 0, B 1, L1 is in on condition. Similarly for A1, B0, so here A1 and B0. Again at this position L1 is in on condition. So this is the verification of XOR gate. So this is all about this Logicom 2. Now we are going to proceed with the next module, that is Logicom 3. And for this Logicom 3, we have the next manual for this Logicom module, that is 38613 manual. So this is the manual for Logicom 3. So again, for Logicom 3, our first experiment is the verification of OR gate and NOR gate. So this is the OR gate and this is the NOT gate. So we have to give the output of first NOR gate to input to the another NOT gate. So to understand the OR gate and NOR gate functions, we have to take the input A and B. So here I am taking the input A on input and input B output of OR gate on LED L1 and the output of OR gate is the input for NOT gate and output of NOT gate to the LED L2. Turn on the training board. Now when input A and B 00, so this is the truth table given in the manual. So when input A 0, B 0, output of OR gate 0 and output of NOR gate 1. So here when A 0, B 0, output of OR gate 0 and output of NOR gate 1. So L1 is in off condition and L2 is in on condition. When input A0, B1 at this position, L1 on and L2 is in off condition. So you can see here L1 is in on condition and L2 is in the off condition. Similarly for A1 and B0, at this position again L1 is in on condition and L2 is in off condition. So you can see L1 is in on condition and L2 is in off condition. So this is all about this experiment. Now we are going to verify the second experiment, that is a verification of AND gate and NAND function. So we are going to use the AND gate and pass the output of AND gate to the input of NOT gate and we are going to observe the output of NOT gate. So to understand this AND gate and NAND gate functions, first of all make the connection as shown in the figure 3 of 38613 manual. For this experiment I am going to use the input A and B. So here connect the input A and input B output of AND gate on LED L1 and the pass the output of 74082 input to the NOT gate to observe the output of NAND gate. So output of NOT gate to LED L2. Turn on the training board. Now we are going to verify the output. So when A0, B1 at this position, output of AND gate 0 and output of NAND gate 1. So when A0 and B1 at this position, L1 is in off condition and L2 is in on condition. You can see here L1 is in off condition and L2 is in on condition. For A1, B1, L1 is in on condition and L2 is in off condition. So when A1 and B1 So when AB 11, L1 is in on condition and L2 is in off condition. So this is all about this experiment. So you can also perform the all experiment. So this is the experiment of Boolean functions. This is the exclusive OR gate functions. So you can perform all the experiment using our manual and Logicom 3. So this is all about the Logicom 3. Now we are going to understand the Logicom 4, that is experiment of JK flip-flop. So using this Logicom 4, we are going to verify the up counter and down counter. So to understand this Logicom 4, we are going to use this 38614 manual of Logicom 4. So now our first experiment of Logicom 4 is the up counting. So in up counting, we are going to use the 4 flip-flop, flip-flop 1, flip-flop 2, flip-flop 3 and flip-flop 4. So last flip-flop is our MSB and first flip-flop is our LSB. So for up counter, we are going to use the asynchronous circuit. So in asynchronous, the output of first flip-flop is the clock for second flip-flop. Output of second flip-flop is the clock for third flip-flop, and output of fourth flip-flop is the clock for last flip-flop. Short all the preset, input of flip-flop, similarly connect these preset shorted input to pulsar 2. Similarly short all the clear inputs and again connect the all shorted clear input to pulsar 2 and connect clock input of flip-flop 1 to pulsar 1. Now turn on the training board. Now press this clear switch again and again till all the LED will glow. Till then you have to press this clear switch. So at this time all LED of flip-flop 1, flip-flop 2, flip-flop 3 and flip-flop 4 are glowing. It means we have to start the giving clock one by one. So you can see all LED are glowing. So I am giving first clock using the pulsar 1. So at this time we are getting the output 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So this is the up counting. I am taking this decimal number by converting the 8421 code. So you can understand this up counting. For down counting, what you have to do, you have to just change the q to q bar, q to q bar, q to q bar. So this is the connection. So at this time in down counting, you have to press the clear till all the LED will in off condition. Now start giving the clock by using the pulsar one. So we are starting with the 15. This is 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and lastly 1. So this is all about the down counting. So you can make this connection by observing the manual. So here I have made it the figure 5 for down counting and figure 4 for the up counting. So this is all about the down counting and up counting. So this is all about this Logicom 4. So here I have performed all the experiment, some experiment of Logicom 1, Logicom 2, Logicom 3 and Logicom 4. So this is all about this logic laboratory. In this logic laboratory, the best thing, we have provided you the storage space for your stationary products or for patch codes. So you can use this space as your needs, and you can buy this product from India Mart by using the order code 38615, and you can also log in through our website www.tesca.in. So this is all about this logic laboratory. So thank you for watching this video. For other queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited, and you can also go through over these manuals. Thank you.